I struggled here to get into the master's school because my bachelor from India was just only 3 years, and here in America, bachelor is 4 years.
Hey friends, welcome to Chiang Coaching. Rob here. In this video, we're gonna talk about some issues that students face. One is having a 3-year degree abroad, and if that can help or hurt you trying to study, especially like a master's here in America, and also the green card, whether green cards are helpful or not for studying here in America. So grab some chai and join us in this video. All right, friends, thanks for joining us. Disha here is a very unique situation. She's gonna talk about the struggles she faced having a 3-year bachelor's in India, and how it was hard for her to study in America. And she's also here on a green card, not an F1 student visa, and kind of the pros and cons about that. So Disha, go ahead and introduce yourself again.
Hello everyone, I'm Disha Patel, majoring in computer science here at UT Dallas. And yes, I'm from Gujarat, India.
You studied computer applications. You have a 3-year undergrad degree.
Yes.
Back in India, and then your family moved to America, right?
Yes.
What was that like?
Me and my family moved to United States in 2015. So that time I recently wrap up my bachelor's in computer applications from India. And then I struggled here to get into the master's school because my bachelor from India was just only 3 years. And here in America, bachelor is 4 years. So I evaluate my degree in World Education Center in New York. And they say that bachelor from India, which is considered here as a 3 years undergrad. So that time I was in the middle of somewhere, like cannot go forward or cannot go back. So, and that day I decide like, okay, I really want to achieve my goal. So no one's gonna be stop me. As long as you decide that you wanna go for it, no one's gonna be stop you. So make sure you clear for your goal. That day I initially 2 years, I work on my family business in Akron, Ohio. And then after, meanwhile, I research on like how to finish a degree here in United States and which school do I need to go for it. And initially days I work on my family business in Akron, Ohio. And meanwhile I research what school I want to go, which career path I want to go, and how all those things gonna be work out. And then after 2017, I moved from Akron, Ohio to Houston, and I started going to Lone Star Community College, and I recently get my associate in computer science from there. And without wasting any semester, once I get my associate from there and I apply here at UT Dallas as a transfer student, and I start my first semester here in summer 2019. I took 9 credits, then after in the fall semester I take 13 credits, and right now I'm taking 16 credits, and now I'm about to graduate this December 2020 by taking 18 credits. So that was kind of really struggle because you really want to go for a 4-year university or for a master, but somehow the education system is not working out for you and you get frustrated and all the stuff is happening. But your biggest motivation is that to start now, not tomorrow. My father is always motivate me like education has no part, because he said that it's okay to start from zero and go step by step to the top level. And that was the biggest motivation, family support and all the stuff.
So we did make a separate video about Disha's transfer process, how she went from a community college to a top 4-year degree here to go from Lone Star Community College to UT Dallas for computer science. So be sure to check that out. We'll have the links available for that. And Disha, now go ahead and just tell us real quick, what are the differences between being on a green card versus an F1 student visa that you have experienced?
So being on a green card is really great advantage is that like on an F1 student too, pay like a way, way, way higher fee compared to having a green card, because you're paying an institution's fee, which is not more than $5,000, which is so cheaper compared to people on a F1 student visa. The another thing is like you're going for a school, so meanwhile you can work anywhere as a part-time, or you can do work study and you get a FAFSA. So that's the really great advantage to having a green card.
So our CHAI question for this video is, here in America, are you on an F1 student visa? Are you here on a green card? Leave a comment and let us know. It'd be fun to see which different ways people are here as internationals. Any other tips you want to give, Disha, just based on your experience from how you studied in India, impacting here, coming, being here, trying to achieve your goals and masters, any final tips?
Yeah, the final tip is that education is the only weapon in a war against the reality. So make sure you clear to your career, your goal, and what career path you want to go.
Awesome. Well, I know that yours isn't the traditional path,
yes,
and that even though you had some issues on getting to your goal as a master's, you're still on it now.
Yeah, and even, I'm on a track right now.
Yeah, and even though they didn't accept your degree in India, you found a different way.
Yeah.
And you went through the community college. Now here at UTD, you're fast-tracking to your master's,
yes,
and it's been fun. Very proud of you for working hard to do that.
So, my dear listener, all I want to say is, like, there is always another way. So if you really, really want to achieve your goal, then no one gonna stop you.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much. If this video was helpful, give a big like and thumbs up to Disha to say thanks to her. And yeah, thanks for joining us. And we'll see you guys next time at CHAI Coaching.
Cheers.
Cheers.